Morjesta ja tervetuloa Rauta. Oh, sorry, let's take it in English. Welcome to Rauta. Today we're gonna talk about some Finnish black metal. This one is Clandestine Blaze with Secrets of Laceration. This came in the end of April 2021. It's the 11th full-length album by Clandestine Blaze. Now, I'm not actually sure in terms of being very anal about it, whether or not we should call it a band or project, because, to be honest, Clandestine Blaze is and has always been one-man operation. Maybe it's actually operation now what I should be referring to, because it's not exactly band as multiple people taking part of creating music, but it's not really a project in the sense of, you know, one kind of a side project which is there to just exist for a couple of years and then vanish into thin air. Clandestine Blaze has been doing its music for more than 20 years now, starting in late 90s, and it was in fact the very first release Northern Heritage label, because they are actually one and the same guy, Mikko Aspa, known and infamous for his various projects. Not limited to Clandestine Blaze, not limited to Northern Heritage, but also his projects in more like noise kind of a side tracks. In addition to metal, he has also his rock and roll project. He has his own record shop. He has done comic books. He has done, well, can I say, adult entertainment. Now, the point here is, he's a man of many talents. He's also known as vocalist of some other bands, but here on this review we're gonna talk about Secrets of Laceration. Now the CD version of the album came out late April. There's no official release date according to Mikko Aspa. I asked him like what would be the release date for this one, because they just came here by the end of April, and he said there is no actual release date. When the CD is out, it's out, it's that simple, and the vinyl version will come out later. So that's pretty much the official information, and that's what we have to live by. Like I said, the vinyl version will be out later. I think it was in June, so those who are vinyl maniacs, hold to your horses while other people are enjoying this on CD, and it seems this is also now available on YouTube for people's listening pleasure. I guess it will be later on appearing in Bandcamp site, sorry, but at least for the time being today, it wasn't right there. So bear with me and hold to your horses, like I said. Now, people who don't know what Clandestine Blaze is as such, well, we could say it's kind of a raw end of black metal, and like I said, it has been there for more than 20 years. This catalog, the discography, is quite vast. And as you can see, in the first years, there were EPs, there were splits, there were, well, collaboration and compilation kind of things. So more or less, it was bounding back and forth between full-length albums and the other kind. But past 10 years or so, well, it has mostly been about full-length albums every couple of years, 2-3 years or so. And again, Clandestine Blaze delivers yet another patch of raw end of black metal. Now, some people have been comparing Clandestine Blaze mostly to Darkthrone. That is according to Metal Archive site when it take a look at similar artists. And I must say, Secrets of Laceration is very, very much something that reminds us of what Darkthrone is doing. That is, there is certain kind of similarity with Darkthrone, what Darkthrone was doing already earlier in 2000s. Now, the later part, when Darkthrone decided to go more about like old school heavy metal and less black metal and all that stuff, now the style has more or less changed. And throughout these 42 minutes, it seems like one track missing its song length. Throughout these 42 minutes and 7 tracks, what strikes me the most is that it's mostly quite mid-tempo or even slow-tempo black metal, but it's very much clinging to its roller end of black metal. It's not ultra-primitive like some of the other bands when you consider about raw black metal, but rest assured this is more on the roller end, which not only reflects in songwriting but also in production. And then again, the production or these roller end kind of violent vocals are very much what has been present with the previous Clandestine Blaze, so nothing has changed that much. One other thing that kind of got me by surprise was that there were quite a lot of synths actually used. But with Clandestine Blaze, the use of synths doesn't really mean it's like some Emperor or Dimmu Borgir kind of a symphonic black metal thing. It doesn't mean overly melodic output, but more like creating these layers which then again add a feeling of rather ghastly appearance. Some people might be considering it's just something that isn't very compatible with Clandestine Blaze's music, but I don't know. For me, it actually works quite well. It's something that comes naturally. It isn't like forcefully added to the music, but it's actually complementing it with something that is not so typical with this kind of black metal. And like I said, there are lots of tempo changes, but mostly it operates with the slower or mid-tempo areas. But there are faster parts with which then again create this diversity, which then again makes the whole album a little bit more interesting rather than sticking to just one style only. Now there are also some rocking elements, there are even guitar solos, or at least one solo that I was like really like figuring out like, okay, what's going on? To be honest, I don't remember that I would have been paying attention on solo guitar on earlier Clandestine Blaze albums. So if you would ask me like which songs Clandestine Blaze have solos, I have no idea. I never figured out it's a kind of a band or operation which would have solos, but well, there are some. It's not like they're like too weird. It's not like they're dominating the songwriting, but just creating a kind of a detail in the music. And in my opinion, once again, it fits quite well. It's not a deal breaker. I mean, it wouldn't matter if that solo or solos were there, but to be honest, I mean, it's one of those seasoning kind of things. It's right there and it doesn't bother whether or not it's going to take place in the music. Now, throughout these 42 minutes, the quality is overall pretty okay, solid all the time. So there are no weak moments as such. But then again, this is not exactly an album that is very catchy. What does it mean in terms of Clandestine Blaze then again is, well, in my opinion, this is not the best nor the worst by Clandestine Blaze. This is a very solid addition to the whole discography by the project or band or whatever you want to call it. But it's not, you know, groundbreaking in any ways. So even though one could say there's some newer things in the music on the album, in my opinion, this is still very much Clandestine Blaze sounding like Clandestine Blaze, which is, of course, a good thing if you are a fan of the earlier works or if you just have liked some albums by the band or project, whatever. So, I don't know. To me, Secrets of Laceration is a good release. It's nothing phenomenal, nothing groundbreaking, but once again, enjoyable album in the field of raw end of black metal. So those who have enjoyed the band previously or have enjoyed what Mikko Aspa is doing should definitely check out this one as well. And like I said, CD is out already and LP will be coming out later on. Check out YouTube in case you cannot see the music appearing on band's Bandcamp site by the time this video gets out. With that, I hope you enjoy it.